Alright, I would like to play first. Well, I'm gonna keep this hand. This hand is great. Actually, kind of interesting how I play this hand. I go Volcanic, Ruby. I actually think I just pass. I don't really want to get turn one Oath, so I want to leave Spell Pierce up. Otherwise, I might play Ancestral with Pyroblast backup. So if my opponent does nothing, I probably just wait and just draw an extra, just draw a card on my turn, play a second land, say go. Preordain. Alright, well now I'm gonna Ancestral and then Pyroblast and Misstep, because I think it's unlikely enough that my opponent has second Mox plus Oath. Am I getting Flusterstormed? No, I'm getting Pyroblasted? I did not see that coming. Alright. Well, that sucks, because I cannot Pyroblast back. Oath with Pyroblast. Okay. I've thought about putting red in Oath for a while, but I have not actually taken the step to do so. I guess my opponent did. Luckily, my hand is still pretty good, but that was a beating. I'm not going to lie. I'm going to put both in the bottom. Preordain. The fourth color in Oath is ambitious. All right, but it worked out here. Let's play a Pyromancer, leaving Pyroblast or Spell Pierce up. I mean, I could have left both up, but I didn't think that was right. Alright, so my opponent turn two Oath with Misstep. Problem is, without that Ancestral Resolving, I can't just sit there, because eventually I will lose to, you know, not doing anything. I do have to pressure my opponent to some degree. Actually, I think I get a Trop here. And I have a chance to hit Grafdigger's Cage even if this Spell Pierce doesn't work. What does my opponent have? Mental Misstep, Hardcast. Alright. Well. Attacks and probe my opponent. What are we facing? Preordain, Regrowth, Time Lock. Geez, a lot of stuff. Alright. Lotus actually helps some. Because now I can play Dak Faden with mana left to play Grafdigger's Cage. Dak Faden. Plus one on myself. Alright. Discard. And Preordain, Regrowth, and Time Walk are not actually gonna stop, you know, me from oathing here, or from shutting down Oath. My opponent can see a bunch of new cards, but has to find an answer reasonably quickly to the Grafdigger's Cage. Alright, so leads with Preordain. Hopefully looking for Abrupt Decay. Opponent put both cards on the bottom. Presumably casting Time Walk. Alright, let my opponent take their turn again. And if they found something, they'll maybe regrowth Time Walk, but otherwise probably regrowthing Preordain here is my guess. No, it looks like they're just getting Time Walk again. Okay. That's just cycling, I guess. I get a token out of the deal, though. So I don't hate that. And I'm going to get to see more cards on my turn. Honestly, if my opponent passes, I'm still just going to Dak Faden to look for a second Grafdigger's Cage. Oh, my opponent found Abrupt Decay. All right. Yeah. I mean, when Oath just has it, like, yeah, my opponent saw some new cards, but, you know, seeing them that quickly was... not, but they weren't favored to hit Abrupt Decay in like the five cards they saw or whatever, four cards they saw. Well, now that Gristlebrand's out, what do I got? Basically no chance. And had I not played Young Pyromancer, my opponent played Oath, I would go Spell Pierce, then Pyroblast, my opponent's Misstep, and then I'd probably play Pyromancer, and then my opponent would Regrowth and replay Oath. Kind of like the same sort of thing would have happened. I don't think it's necessary. I don't think it was right to just sit there and wait. Alright. Will my opponent get to go off this turn? Probably not. We'll see. One reason I do like adding red is Ancient Grudge is a very good answer to Graph Digger's Cage. Not because it lets you flashback and kill the second one, because it doesn't, but just because Ancient Grudge is just a card I really like, so it doesn't cost you that much to play it. Opponent Pyroblasting my Dak Faden. I can't imagine I have many outs regardless.